Welcome folks to Final Fantasy World Vision. Today we're going to take a look-see at another lightning unit. We're going to take a look-see at Raviesse. You might have seen her in my arena video. Raviesse is a paladin. I just got her to a level 120 yesterday. She's got 6.2k HP, 387 attack, which is irrelevant. A good agility, 60 agility, and for a mega rare unit, that is. And then she got some mediocre stat over there. She's got the Hollow Slave Trustmaster, which increased the JP you get. So this could be a nice Trustmaster to have. If you're starting out and you want to farm some JP, you go into the JP quest, you put this Trustmaster on, you put the Ovalite, and then you give some other Trustmaster, like the Anniversary Rewards, to other people, so you can get more AP on others. Let this increase your JP gain. So instead of 10k, you get 13k, which is, I mean, it's something. She's got the Thief and Samurai subjob. That's because of her background. She trained under Master Seymour, I think. No, it's it's Master O. I got them confused, the names. Let's take a look, see at the abilities. Now, she's got all of the samurai and thief subjob abilities. Let's take a look, see at her EX board. Now, we have Bedeviling Blade, deals medium damage to target, so it's a single choose square move, medium damage, it's retarded, useless, do not level this up. Chance of inflicting confusion for 3 turns and reduces AP. Bad. I don't know if this reduces AP, it's all of the AP or sub. If it's all of the AP, it might be worth in place of a mana strike. Otherwise, this move is trash. Okay, the fact that it's two squares makes it very retarded in the current meta we have today. And the medium damage on a two square move, it's just dumb. But we're still talking about a Gen 0 unit, so what did you expect? Now, this enhances Holy Knight protection to Holy Knight's Martyrdom, raises max HP, defense, and hate. So this gives Raviesse some hate. Now you might think, okay, we're getting some hate, we might actually skip the Taunting Blade, but Taunting Blade got upgraded and now it deals large damage. Anyway, moving on to Saintly Cross Enhancement. Enhance Saintly Cross to Blinding Cross, removes all debuff from self, then deals medium damage to targets within area around self and absorb portion of damage dealt, and chance of inflicting blind for 3 turns and raises on evasion rate. This is a good move if you want. She's gonna use it a lot in the auto battles. I think it's a good move, Saintly Cross. This one becomes Blinding Cross. Look, it's a 2 square diamond shaped around self. You can throw her like inside the enemies and you can get a lot of HP back. Also, you can blind them, so it's actually good. For the abilities, she's got acquired AP up level 1. I don't know why they call it level 1, that is not a level 2, but whatever. She's got Blade Soul, raise attack and evasion rate, and lowers defense. Now, she can be very evasive if you put some thought into it. Not like Shadowlings or any other UR unit, but she can probably evade some hits with the right gear and the right moves. But I don't know, she's a paladin. I see the dissonance here, like paladin with evasion, what? I can only focus on one stat. Okay, then we have Thief Lore, which gives me move plus 1 and raise agility. Move plus 1 is great for tanks, and raise agility, it's also great. Holy Knight Martyrdom, honestly, raise max HP, defense and hate. This is standard, you want this. This is guaranteed to stay here. Reaction, she's got Paladin Guard to reduce physical damage. She also has Third Eye, chance of raising own evasion rate for 3 turns when taking damage, stackable 3 times. So this could actually work. As a paladin, you can sustain some damage. The fact that this one triggers and raise your evasion rate for 3 turns means that she can get to some pretty nice evasion levels. Obviously, if you fight against Sephiroth, he's got Shadow Flare, so you're still dead anyway. Then you have quick action. Quick action significantly increases the agility from one turn when taking damage. Again, it's really up to you. I'd say Paladin Guard is more reliable, but you know, if you want to go for an evasion build, go for an evasion build. Subjob, you got Thief, Steel, Steel Art, Steel Time. This is very good in raids. Snipe Dagger, medium damage to 4 squares. And chance of inflicting confusion. So this is basically the Bewildering Blade we got. With the exception it has double the range. Same damage, double the range. Please, someone, Gumi, please tell me the reasoning behind this. When you gave Raviesse the level 120 with the EX job, you didn't look at the abilities right off the game. You don't even know what abilities you have in your own game, because medium damage, 4 squares, Snipe Dagger, and Raviesse has her EX ability, 2 square, medium damage. Still confusion. Like, seriously? You didn't think this through, obviously. Samurai, Devotion, Illusion, Night Veil, Congo. Congo is very nice as an ability. It raises on slash attack, resist a piercing rate, then deals large damage to target within range and piercing, and bestow Machina and Stone Killer. So this is very good. See? 3 squares large damage. You've already lost against this move. Doesn't make sense what they do with the game. They don't even know what they're doing with their own game. They don't even know the abilities that are present. Anyway, I don't see the point of using Samurai, so let's go into the far plane and test this unit out. Let's see if I have something unlocked. I don't know. I've been kind of slacking in this game because I just can't take this game anymore. It's just boring to me. We can do this one. Have I done this one? No. Well, I guess we'll have to do... Let's do this one. Why not? Okay, the team is the same, all the same. We've got two slashing members. We got Nivlu, we got Silmang, we got Queen. So it's a mixed bag. So this gives you an average idea of damage. Okay, she's not, it's not focused on slashing. It's not my, ooh, why do we have this one? I need to change the vision cards. I need to give you a decent vision card so you can actually do some tanking. So, well, since this is a not PvP area, we can go with the defense here. Take defense 15, speed up 15, and just go from there. Now, technically, we could go even higher than 73 defense. We can take out this one and give even more defense. We could go with the Chocobo, honestly. So, we can go with this one, or you can give her like this one. With the... No, not this one. This one. With defense and spirit up 5. It's really, it's up to you. I don't know what to do. Max HP is great. So, it's dead. Let's just drop on the ground and see what we can do. I mean, 5 defense is not gonna be groundbreaking. Probably gonna transform into 7. I'm gonna reach 80 defense. Okay. What do we have here? We have fire and we have water and light. Oh, this one I do remember. Oh, this is such a bad... It doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. Okay, let's... Okay, Nivlu, you're gonna do Strongbow Stance. Silma, you need to go and do something like Fast Cast Protection on her Queen. Queen is gonna do something. I always forget what Queen abilities do. Motorbiking there, her way there. Okay. Okay, Raviesse. Just go over here. Stick your ass in here and just... No, do not taunt. You do not do damage. Just sit here on a sentinel and everything will be a-okay. Okay, just sit there. I will pardon your intrusion, Shuzet. I will. One day. Inherited Tyranny, nice, let's get this going. Set up the DPS. There you go. She is not taking any damage. Okay, please stop. I have a tank, Can you please let me tank? Okay, so Niblu, what can you do? Honestly, you got... Oh, you can do... Oh, do that. Go for Spider Rain. Niblu doing good jobs. Good job over there. Okay, what can you do? Jamming Trust. I'd rather jump Trust the mage. Thank you very much. No healing for you. Okay, and you're gonna do Atomic Flare probably, okay. Yeah, whatever. Shut up, Squeen. Okay. Now, I can see the opportunity here to land a Taunting Blade. Well, actually, I see many opportunities. You're definitely not gonna do anything here, so just lob a Taunting Blade, get some aggro. Kill these two guys. She's very good at tanking right now. Now, a Zerg break on these guys. And this should give me the ability to, well, pick one off, honestly. This one. There you go. And now Chunak and company. Ooh, the White Mage and the Marilith. Ooh, boy. She got it with the Paladin Guard. Poison. That's not good. We'll have to remove the poison. Okay, next. What do we have here? We have Frey, according to the AI. Okay, so, Silma. Listen, buddy. You have Purify, though. You have Purify, so remove the poison. That would be great. Okay, protecting the Marilith, no problem there. Okay, you might want to consider revitalizing yourself. You shall not fail, that's what you say. Okay, look this side. She's taking damage like a boss. It's nothing, really, truly, it's nothing. Okay, now, you. My Fredine, take care of these guys, please. If you'd be so kind. Okay, Niblu doing dispel spread. Ooh. But what if I want to kill the mage? I want to kill the White Mage, honestly. No, I just want to kill the White Mage. Barrier Obliterator, sure. Just one hit KO this guy. Chunak is gonna do Chunak things. Alright, so. Shuzelt, what you gonna do now? No, Shuzelt, listen, buddy. We need... Ooh, Paralyzing Edge on this dude. Can we do anything else? No, Paralyzing Edge is fine. Okay. Take care of the poison. There you go. And now we can focus on something else, like taking care of Chunak, for instance.
Gotcha!
Okay. The White Mage comes. We don't care about the White Mage here. Alright, so we can use the Phoenix as an Esper to get the HP back. No problem there, but we need a Taunting Blade. So Bedeviling Blade does nothing. Blinding Cross will probably give me some HP back. Not too many. Because of the damage. The Taunting Blade is gonna be the 8-up maneuver. Okay, White Mage going Protect. Yeah, I can see how that works. Let's go Auto, as we are pretty much done here. I think she's a very good tank for a Lightning unit. I don't know how many tanks Lightning has. Look at that. Look at that. She just takes damage like crazy, she doesn't care. She just stays there. I think she's a very solid unit. What I am disappointed in is the damage. The damage is absolutely non-existential, even as a tank. She's got low damage output, so... But I mean, she is doing a great job of staying alive. Got Council, okay, Regen, good job, White Mage, you're very intelligent. Now please. My abilities go through wall, but gunners still cannot shoot through walls. That's fantastic. And there you go, the blinding cross got in. Okay, so what do we think about this unit? Ooh, if I didn't background repeat this one, I would probably be yay. But no, no. So what do I think about this? I think it's a great unit. We don't have many paladins in this game, so I think actually having her on lightning. Look, I don't have all the units in the game because mostly limited units I do not possess, but I don't see many tanks in this roster. Okay, aside from Charlotte is not physical, really. You shouldn't use her as a physical tank. She has some interesting abilities that gives her protect, but I mean, she's definitely good, but you know, use her for magic, that's better. If you want to go physical, I think Raviesse is the better option compared to Charlotte, I think. Now, that being said, she's a mega rare unit. Charlotte is ultra rare. I shouldn't be really comparing her to Charlotte. But you don't have anyone else here able to tank, and she's going to be very useful in your selection quest. Not necessary, not mandatory, because I got Vern here. I mean, you don't need Raviesse. In my baby account, I did the selection quest with Lisette, Silma, those 220. Then I got like Learte, Veln, and the last one was, I think it was Salir. Salir. Okay. So you don't need Raviesse. But she's a good addition, I think. If you want to go and max her out, I wouldn't fault you, but she's a mega rare unit. Again, I think most people will go for ultra rare units and do not care about mega rare units. Again, I completely understand that the point is that most people probably want to play the arena and don't care much about the PvE, non-existent PvE content of this game. Anyway, this was the unit. Hopefully you got something out of this video, so thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.